In this tutorial, we will show you the two most common uses of MixMinus in Wirecast. First, for users who don't want to listen to their own voice. And second, for users who want to eliminate feedback loops coming from shots which use the computer system's audio, such as screen captures of Skype calls or videos playing inside of a browser. A MixMinus signal is really just an audio output to a certain device that contains everything except the audio from specific or selected devices. This is particularly useful when you want to listen to your audio through Wirecast's monitor output, but not hear certain audio signals. Or perhaps more importantly, prevent the microphones hooked into Wirecast from hearing their own signals, which would result in a feedback loop. The audio mixer enables you to monitor and control all of the audio sources from a single control panel. To open the audio mixer, select Audio Mixer from the window menu. The audio mixer separates your audio by hardware and shot. Live sources area is located to the left of the master control. This area contains all audio sources that are currently live in your streaming event. Whatever your audience hears will be listed in this area. In this example, I have two live audio sources. One coming from my computer's built-in microphone, and the other coming from a screen capture of video playing within a browser. There are two potential problems here. First, I will certainly hear my own voice unless I remove my built-in microphone from the monitor mix. Secondly, if I don't have headphones, then the sound from the video playing out of my computer speakers will be picked up by my microphone, which will result in an echo and feedback loop. This is a good situation to use MixMinus and remove my built-in microphone from the monitor mix to avoid both of these problems. Please note it's always a good idea to wear headphones when you have a hot mic in the room, since a MixMinus will only solve the feedback problem and not the echo. In Wirecast, there are two ways to remove an audio source from the monitors. If the source is live, you can remove it from the audio mixer by clicking on the monitor button located at the bottom of the source. If the source is not live, you can remove it from the System Device Properties tab located in the Shot Editor panel. If you have an audio device selected, in this case my built-in microphone, then you will see a monitor checkbox at the bottom of the System Device Properties tab. Uncheck it to remove the audio source from the monitors. Again, your audience will still be able to hear this source when it's live, but you won't be able to hear it in your monitors. Congratulations! We've just created our first MixMinus feed. This will eliminate the echo that I hear of my own voice, but my audience will still be able to hear me. However, we still have a problem with our screen capture audio. Because Wirecast has a virtual microphone that is listening to the computer audio, it will also hear any audio coming out of the monitors, which results in a nasty audio feedback. There are two ways to fix this. The first solution is to, again, remove the screen capture audio from the monitors like we did with my built-in microphone. This solution is quick and useful, but has a downside. You can't mix what you can't hear. By default, Wirecast sends audio to your computer's built-in output, which is the same output that your computer system audio uses. This could be your computer speakers, headphones, or your default sound card. Most of the time, this isn't a problem, but when you have a local screen capture and you want to capture the audio from your computer, in this case audio from my video playing in a browser, and at the same time you want to simultaneously mix your Wirecast audio and listen to your Wirecast monitors, you will need to route your Wirecast audio to a different output to avoid feedback loops. Wirecast provides two ways to change your audio monitor output device. In the audio mixer at the bottom of the master control area, click the drop-down list and choose a different audio output device. You can also change this output in the Wirecast Preferences menu using the Audio Interface drop-down menu. In this example, I changed the default audio output to a connected USB audio device that has a second set of headphones plugged into it, avoiding any feedback loops.